Hey everyone, my name is Jax, and in this video we're going to be going over how to play 7 Days to Die. This is meant for beginners, it's not really meant for intermediate or advanced players, it's meant for beginners because I've noticed that there are a lot of rudimentary questions on some forums. This is mainly meant to help you get started with the game, might lead into something a bit bigger, you know, maybe a let's play, but for now, I'm going to just show you, you know, what I do in order to succeed in the game and how you can do so as well. I mean, I've lasted over hundreds of days in this game. Very fun game. But nevertheless, this is the version that we're on, and we're just going to start a fresh game. Excuse me if the music is too loud. I did lower it, but this game does like to blare the music. So this is a setting that we're going to be on. It's just a pregen K1. I believe K1 is... It could be any of the pregens, but specifically one with K1 at the end. Like, see here, there's K2, K3, K4... I'm just choosing a pregen 6K1 just because of the world size, and also K1 means that there is a pine forest in the middle of where you should be starting. We'll see if that remains true, but nonetheless, this is just a map. Let's go ahead and stick with that. These are our settings. I'm not touching any of these things, just so you know we're aware. Also, this is what we're looking at here. So this is all the default stuff. I'm not really touching any of this, not really touching any of that here, and multiplayer doesn't really apply to us because it'll be a single player game, but that is what we're looking at. So nevertheless, let's go ahead and get started. And as you load into the game, you will see these hints and tips at the bottom. So if you want to, you know, you can just click through them and read them just to kind of get different information. But they do have some important things in here, so make sure you do take a look at these if you, you're still new with the game. So, all right, let's go ahead and spawn in. And it seems that we are, in fact, in a pine forest. And as soon as you spawn in, you will have a tutorial. And it's a decent tutorial, but it's not good for helping you with mid- and late game stuff. It basically just tells you how to make some basic tools and how to find the trader. So let's go ahead and do that. So go ahead and open the challenge window. And honestly, this is all stuff that you could pretty much do yourself. And these things are going to be challenges. You can redeem these for experience. As you can see, this thing is trying to teach us how to redeem challenges. You also have the advanced challenges here too, but we'll figure those out later. But for now, it wants us to, you know, do this one, which is, and you just click redeem, and usually you will get some sort of experience for it. So the next one would be to do this one. So basically we're just going to do this whole line, this whole trader quest line, and then from there I believe the rest open up, and then you could look at to see like what's required of each one of these, and you know what it's going to give you to complete it. So it's good for leveling up. That's another way of playing the game. But nonetheless, let's go ahead and do what they're asking for. So it's saying gather plant fibers, gather wood, gather small stone. And then you can punch with the left click if you're playing on PC. Not sure what it is on console, but in this case, we're playing on PC. You could see it's kind of like telling us like where to punch. Like it's telling us like this this dried up shrub. If we punch it, you can see at the bottom right, two wood planks plus some EXP. Pretty sweet. So let's go ahead and get a bit more wood. There we go. We got 10 wood. So now we want to gather also some stone. You can see it's still showing us where the stone is. And let's go ahead and gather that. Gather more stone. Boom. Boom. All right. So now there's no more icons, right? It's like, well, where do we get plant fibers? Funny enough, you actually just get it from this grass. You punch the grass, even though it's not telling you where to get it. I think it would just flood the screen, but yeah, you just punch these little plants. It's not a big deal. And after that, we go ahead and press tab, and you can see here it's wanting us to build a stone axe. So let's go and do that. And these are the items that we need to build it, and then we just click craft, boom, and we want to drag that here, so we hold it in our inventory or our hot bar. So harvesting wood and harvest small stone. So I don't think that's stone. I think that's something else. So we want to gather wood the same way we did. We could do this. You know, that, but we can also hit the tree. You can see that it's a lot quicker. The rate at which we gather wood is a lot quicker. So that is pretty sweet. And then again, just harvest small stones. We can, I believe we can actually harvest stones by this. Yeah, so we could just hit this giant rock right here and gather some stones. There we go. So let's go ahead and press tab. Make a primitive outfit and craft with W. You can press W here instead of left clicking it. That is an option, but we are making a primitive outfit. There we go. We wear it by pressing W as well, or just clicking the wear button. And now it wants us to craft a wooden club for some defense. Good enough. There we go. And you can see all the stats here. It's listed. So let's go ahead and put that in our hotbar just in case, you know, something does come our way and we need to take care of business. There we go. I like to organize my inventory as such. You could do it however you want. Let's also make a bow. There we go. Perfect. And we'll put that also in our inventory. And then we need to gather some feathers in order to make this arrow. So as you can see, it is showing us where we could find nests. As you can see, there is actually only one nest in the area. They will be on the ground, so keep your eyes peeled for that. And wow, look at that, 9 feathers. That is pretty sweet. So to make one, that's what it takes. You don't actually have to drag this down here. You can just keep it in your inventory, and it will automatically do it. So I would like to craft a few more though. So I'm gonna go ahead and craft that many. Actually, I'm gonna craft as much as I can. So get a few more, there we go. I'm gonna use all the feathers that we have, plus one more rock. So let's go ahead and get that. There we go. All right, so now we have a healthy amount of stone arrows. So go ahead and hold open the radial to select challenges. So in this case, we're just holding tab, or you know, you can also press Y. But in any case, let's go ahead and redeem. Redeem, redeem, redeem. Just pressing W, just pressing W. W, W. There we go. So now it's telling us where to go to find a trader. And I can already see to our left over here. You can actually tell there's a trader here. One by, I believe the flag tells it's a trader, but two, usually smoke is a trader. Good job, survivor. You've proved to be capable of much potential. We have marked your location in the nearest White River outpost location. There you'll find a trader where you can buy and sell goods and trade stories with one of our friendly citizens. Welcome aboard, Noah. So we can go over there. I would also like to make a bedroll, so when if I die, I can have a certain spawn, and we'll figure out like a good spawn here pretty soon. But now we have enough for a bedroll. I'm actually going to go ahead and craft one. But let's go ahead and check out what this trader is about. And you'll see that it is a very well occupied or defended place. You would think, oh, why can't I just live here? The game actually prevents that from happening, unfortunately. So as much as it does suck, you cannot live in here. And you can see here,
you're not bringing counterfeit money in here, are you?
Trader Wrecked, he is an extremely friendly person, loved by many, but nonetheless, he is usually the beginner trader, so you are stuck with.
Well, look here, boys, we got ourselves a real life hero, and now he wants to be paid. Try anything.
So you can see what they're selling, but in this case, we actually have no money. But you can see plenty of things that are being sold here. If we could, you know, we would buy some, but right now there's not really much for us to buy because one, I don't see actually that he's selling any weapons, so
well, how
not
about
interesting.
You browse your ass right out of my store.
So here is a quest that you can do. It's a job, intro buried supplies. Let's go ahead and take it.
It's a deal. Disappoint
so,
me. And you'll find
they did give us
a
shovel, so that's perfect for us to do. Pretty easy quest, actually. But nonetheless, he did give us something. You can actually search through his things at the beginning. I don't think he minds. It's just like, to him, it's just like garbage. Like, here, you can check this out. And hey, look, we found another stone shovel. More lead. So just a bunch of random things that you could search for. Get in the habit, especially early game. Oh, look at that. We already found an engine. That's actually pretty darn good. Get in the habit early game to continually search for things. Just rummage through stuff. It's really good. So we do want this. That is food. This is rotting flesh. It does have its purpose, believe it or not. But in this case, we don't really have much use for it just yet. But in any case, we'll go ahead and go into the city. I'd like to see if there is a building we can kind of set up in as a home base. So I'm actually going to look around. You can see in the bottom left corner, I am moving faster than usual. I'm actually out of stamina right now. It's because I have running set, and you can actually just tab or press shift once and you'll stop running, or you can continue to run. So up to you on if you want to be running or not, but typically I like to run just because I like to get to places quicker. And I just like to loot things. I think looting is, you know, how you set yourself up for success in this game, especially early on, because you're going to be wanting to grab as much stuff as you can. Right now, I know we could be going to that that quest, but I'm also looking for a nice place to set up camp. And the one thing that I'm looking for, there's actually a certain buildings that I look for setting up a base. And that's a nice concrete wall. Actually, I can actually hear someone hacking. Yeah, he's just attacking that. Interesting, attacking that bus. Or they are, right? Hey, look, so we got our first zombie. Not to fear, though, we did make our club, so just smack him across the head. You can also, I think right-click does a power attack, so that is also helpful. And let's also see, look, we got some canned food. Pretty sweet, we got some seed, some wood. I don't know why wood it was doing in a produce, but in any case, we'll take it. Always want to take everything. As much as you think it might look like trash, you could literally just store it in something later. And if you need it, great. If you don't, well, you know, you could throw it out later. But for now, we want to pick up as much as we can. I'm looking through here. I funny enough, I actually see I see some pretty decent spots. So I don't like the motel. I think this is pretty decent. The reason why I actually kind of like this is because it's concrete. And there's also a ladder to get up. I believe they can also climb too, so let's go ahead and let them climb up, and then we'll take care of business. There we go. Not down though. You gotta wait. You gotta see that EXP appear. See? So now we know they're down because we got 400 experience in the bottom right corner. But I kind of like this just because it's on a roof. But we're going to go ahead and keep looking to see if we could find anything better. I do like that. That is a pretty nice place to be. Bare minimum stuff around it. So, pretty nice setup. We might actually take that. We'll see though. We'll see what else is in the area. But this is looking like a pretty good contender. It's got a decent fence around it. I like that the concrete is in the back. So I would only have to worry about one side, really. Wasn't that crazy? Just jump that. They just jumped over that. Jumped over that that cart like nothing. Go. All right, 400 more experience. Pretty good. This is looking pretty decent. You know, kind of can close this up. And again, make sure that you are always searching for these. And just grabbing whatever's inside. All right, so let's go ahead and take care of some business here. Not a big deal. We are getting low on on stamina there, so you could see we weren't able to attack. But now this thing is attacking our what could be our base. So what should we do about that? Well, we can go ahead and open this up and go ahead and go to them to kind of get them to stop attacking. Again, not a big deal. We did take a hit. Luckily, we didn't get infected, because if you get hit, you could get infected. So, with that being said, I do like this spot, one, because this high spot, and two, it's pretty secure for the most part. That's what I like about it. Let's go ahead and make sure there's nothing in here. Let's clear this out. Yep, see, so there is a person in here. We did take a hit. Not the worst thing, but not the best thing either. All right, there we go. All done. So this is looking pretty decent. You know, we got a small room that we can kind of hold up in, and if things get hairy, we can climb up over here and get out of here. The only problem is, I guess, like, roaming zombies can see us pretty easily. That is, I guess, one downfall this spot. So, but we'll see. But for now, let's go ahead and loot, just make sure that there's nothing else in here. Usually that there's stuff hiding in air grills like that, so we always want to check. All right, pick that up, because we can actually scrap it, believe it or not. Let's go ahead and take care of this person as well, just to conserve our well, now we got two. We don't want to fight two at once, so maybe not just yet. But it looks like we've drawn the attention, so that's fun. Well, let's go ahead and fight. Alrighty. One down, one to go. And just like that, we're good. So I think I'm going to go ahead and, just for now, I'm just going to put down my bedroll. Because that kind of is my sleeping area. I'll put it there. Why not? Nice little nook and cranny. So these are actually really helpful. You'll want to get these every time you see them and use them. So make sure to use them. If the book is closed, if the book is open, then you have no purpose with it. Or it has no purpose to you because you've already seen it and you've already read it. But in this case, we haven't. I mean, we haven't done anything with it. But you could read through it. This allows us to craft armor-piercing robotic turret ammo. Sounds pretty advanced, so don't worry about it just yet. But for now, we can at least read it to get the bonuses that come with it. But also, let's go ahead and make a land claim block. That should help with any problems that we come across in terms of... we need five more. But this will... You can read all about it, but it protects the zone, other players in PvP, and prevents zombie respawns. Up to three land claim blocks can be placed. So we want to place one down as soon as possible to kind of claim our territory. So let's go ahead and do that. Go. So we have claimed... We've claimed the spot. Here we go. Let's see if there are... Actually, it looks like there might be some wood in here. Yep, there is. Go ahead and get a bit more. One more. Should do it. Perfect. The reason why I wanted some wood was to make this. I want to store some of these items that we have. Also, I don't need this. This is literally just for looks. But what's great about this is you scrap it. Six leather, that's huge. Like, leather is actually kind of hard to come by in this game. So to see six leather right off the bat, pretty insane. So let's go ahead and place this down. Let's put it there, right near the door. I don't need most of this. Most of these items I actually don't need, so let's go ahead and put this away. Boom. And I also don't need this either. These can be helpful, so I'm kind of pull them away from the rest of the group. Just because I might need them for later. But in any case, one thing you also want to look at is how hungry you do get and how thirsty you get. So right now, this is what we're at. This will slowly go down. I believe once it gets to a certain amount, I think like halfway, you'll see a notification that says, hey, you're hungry, or hey, you're thirsty. But let's go ahead and actually use this one. This will give us food, water, and health, and we could use some of that. So let's go ahead and use it. And so that we eat it, and bada bing, bada boom, it's healing us and satiating some of our hunger and some of our thirst. We could eat these, but as you can see, there is a chance for dysentery, which is not good. This will actually reduce our health too, but it will satiate our water. But it is just dirty water. So, but like I said, there is a chance for getting dysentery, which you don't want. We do start with some food and some clean water, so do keep that in mind. But it's only meant to hold you over just for a bit. Let's go ahead and close that door. And then let's get out of here. We'll see if there's anything else that tickles our fancy, but I can see there's already a desert biome right over there, which is, that might be desert or a burnt forest, I don't know, but it kind of looks like a desert to me. But let's go ahead and take a look at that quest we picked up, because we still have not done anything. So you can see there are three skulls above me, or it's three skulls on that name up there. That's to show how difficult the point of interest is, and that's, you know, buildings like that are points of interest. That's a point of interest. That's a point of interest. They're called POIs. So if you see that, that's what they mean by that, point of interest, POI. And I'm just gonna hit these as we walk by. Also pick up these rocks. There's a reason why we want to pick all this up, because I actually want to craft some armor that requires this. So I'm going to avoid any zombies for now, just because zombies can be problematic. Start intro to buried supplies quest. Well, if we have no choice, we will fight. So let's go ahead and actually try our trusty bow. So you knock it, you aim, and then ideally get a headshot. But for some reason, bows this early on actually don't do a lot of damage. So we could be shooting them in the face a few times. And it took three shots, which you would think, you know, maybe one or two, but three? It's a lot, especially for headshots, so. But you can see this yellow ring here. It's telling us to dig in this area, so let's go ahead and start digging. As you can see, we are slowly chipping away at this health of this area, and boom, we have made a hole. So we want to keep going, we want to keep digging, just to find out what is underneath and hopefully find those buried supplies that Rekt was talking about. And then Rekt might give us something good in return, but it is a introduction to buried supplies nonetheless, so it is probably a relatively easy quest. And this is, I mean, for the most part, it's a low stakes quest that doesn't involve too much. I mean, usually the ring is much bigger, but in this case, this ring is actually smaller. But maybe on future quests, the ring might be much bigger. So I wouldn't stress about it too much, though. It's pretty simple for the most part. But we'll see. We'll see if we find something. It feels like we keep hitting different spots, though. And as you can see, the ring actually shrunk because after a certain amount of hits on the ground, or after a certain amount of blocks that you remove from the ground, the ring will shrink, thus showing us the correct direction of where the buried supplies could be. And so far we haven't found anything. It's probably a lot deeper if I had to guess, but sometimes these intro quests are nice to us and they don't make it too deep, but we'll see. And we already found it. I mean, that was relatively quick. So search buried food stash. So we have just a lot of rotten flesh, murky water, and old sham sandwich. So a lot of things that aren't necessarily healthy. And I think once you find something like that, it will spawn zombies. So we do want to take care of this. We can also run away from it too. These aren't necessarily fast moving zombies. And once they're knocked down like that, it's a good time to go ahead and start wailing down on them. Because they're kind of stunned in that sense, so it's easier for us to do a bit of ground and pound to get some free hits in. So as you remember, I was wanting to gather some of these things, or gather some of these supplies, because I want to crate these. These are our beginner items, so let's go ahead and crate that. The hood is kind of creepy looking, I will admit. I don't like how it looks, but it is the beginner outfit, so this is what we look like now. Again, kind of creepy, right? Protection is protection, so we'll take it nonetheless. So let's go ahead and just continue onward, upward and onward, and let's actually turn in this quest and see what Rekt hopefully gives to us in terms of a reward. And I believe he will give us a little bit of money as well, so let's be on the lookout for that. And again, I'm just collecting things, so this is actually the currency that we get. So if you see that, always collect it, because that is currency that can be used at traders. So always pick those up. Very good for you. Boom. It's good to see that we're seeing a lot of bird nests. Obviously, that is not indicative of real life unless you live in an area that has a lot of ground birds. But usually you wouldn't find that many nests on the ground. But just in this game, keep your eye on the ground. For bird nests, just because I guess there's a lot of birds that like to lay nests on the ground here. Alright, and you see we keep slowing down. It's because we keep running out of stamina. Looks like there is someone or something sitting in the front of the base. So we'll go ahead and use a side entrance so we don't attract too much attention. And usually these have multiple entrances, so that way we can utilize entering and exiting without too much problems. There we go. And see, just like that, we're back in.
Okay, fucker. You respect the shop rules and we'll get along. Well, I guess I'm going to have to pay you now that you did it.
So there are a few things that you could select from here. Which one's the best? In my opinion, the safest bet would be the pipe baton, just because it is a melee weapon and it doesn't use ammunition, where these will. All these will. The second best thing is probably pipe machine gun or pipe pistol. I'm actually going to lean towards, and this might be against the grain here, I think pipe machine gun's probably better, but pipe pistol is also a safe bet too. Just because it uses the 9mm ammo, and usually 9mm ammo is something that we want, you find a lot of in the game. So this is probably a safe bet, but a pipe machine gun right off the bat is also pretty sweet. Pipe shotgun, not the greatest. I know it sounds really enticing, same with the rifle, but both of these are one shots. They take extremely long to load, reload. And usually that one shot isn't enough to put him down. But I gotta say, I am torn between the machine gun and the pistol. I'm almost leaning towards the pistol just because of the abundance of ammo that you find in the game with this. And the machine gun's sweet too, just because it's your first like automatic gun that you get. And it will help you get out of some pretty hairy situations. But I gotta say, I don't know which one I'd like to choose, just because they're both good in their own rights, but one for more than the other. They have their pros and cons. I think in this case I will choose, I think I'm gonna go with the pistol. I think we'll be okay with the pistol. I imagine that we're just gonna find a lot of 9mm. Also, I usually go with agility perks. I tend to go with agility perks, and I'll explain that later. But let's go ahead and select pipe pistol, and then we can also see if there's any other jobs he has. We can clear the zombies. Let's go ahead and choose that. It's pretty close.
Next time,
and look at that.
Bathe before coming to a job interview.
Let's go ahead and open up this pipe pistol bundle. So we get a pistol with 15 ammo, so not a lot, but it will get the job done. So let's go ahead and load that up. And as you can see, we only have 15 shots, so we have to be very aware and cognizant of when we choose to use a pistol, because one, it's loud, and two, we don't have much ammo. But in any case, that will be it for now. I'm going to go ahead and hop off here, and we'll continue this next time. Have a good one.